The wireless motion sensor makes it fun and easy to study the motion of almost anything. The wireless motion sensor is able to track the motion of most objects up to 4 meters away. It accomplishes this by sending out a series of ultrasonic pulses to reflect off the object. It detects the reflections and finds the round-trip travel time. The position of the object is automatically calculated using the time and the speed of sound. The calculations are repeated at the specified sample rate. The velocity and acceleration of the object are calculated from the position data. The position of objects between 0.15 and 4 meters can be measured with a resolution of 1 millimeter. Data for small objects that are close, like a mass on a spring, can be improved by changing the default setting from long to short range in the software. The rotating head makes for easy and accurate aiming to ensure a good reflection of the ultrasonic pulses. The Bluetooth connection makes it possible to place the wireless motion sensor anywhere you want, even on a moving cart. The rechargeable battery lasts throughout a day full of lab periods. The wireless motion sensor can be used on any horizontal surface, but it offers a wealth of other mounting options, from the built-in rod attachment to a threaded hole on the bottom. The track mount clips make it easy to measure the motion of dynamic carts. Studying the motion of an object in free fall can be a challenge because it happens so fast. Students will have no trouble obtaining high-quality data if they use the wireless motion sensor. Skeptical? Let me show you. I connected the wireless motion sensor to SparkView software using the Bluetooth connection. PASCO Capstone software can also be used. I created a position, velocity, and acceleration graph and changed the sample rate to 50 hertz. After pointing the rotating head straight up, I can drop the basketball and watch the data appear on the display. Let's zoom in on the time when the basketball was falling. It's easy to show that the slope of the velocity graph is about the same as the value of the constant acceleration. So we got -9.9 for the slope, -9.91 for this point here in the middle anyway. That's pretty good. Students can discover other relationships between these graphs using SparkView's analysis tools. Students will want to know how things will change if the basketball is given an upward toss at the beginning. Some might wonder how a beach ball or a balloon would differ. With the wireless motion sensor, they have the tool they need to answer their questions. Additional information about the wireless motion sensor can be found on the product page of the PASCO website. Dozens of free lab downloads for the wireless motion sensor can be found in the PASCO experiment library. Thanks for watching.